Unintended consequences, a term used to describe a set of results that was not intended as an outcome. The NCAA is getting a dose of that now. The NCAA recently approved a rule allowing a transferred player to play immediately if their former university misled them in the recruiting process. I'm here with Dan Wolken, who has uncovered a story that may have massive implications on the college football landscape. Dan, give us the details on the story that you're reporting out of Texas A&M.
Santino Marquial, a linebacker who started his career at Texas A&M, has submitted a statement to his school and also to the NCAA alleging a number of NCAA violations while he was at Texas A&M under Jimbo Fisher. He believes that this set of allegations, which caused him, in his words, to transfer, will be the key to him getting eligible to play this season as opposed to sitting out a year and then being eligible in 2019. And it really brings up an interesting question overall for the NCAA, which is, if players have knowledge of NCAA violations at their previous school, is that a get out of jail free card if they want to leave and be eligible to play the next season?
So if it is a get out of jail free card, then what does this mean for the NCAA and their transfer rules?
Well, the NCAA has really been wrestling over the last year with how to deal with the transfer issue, but this rule that the NCAA put in this year is kind of a great example of how the waiver process and all the different rules they try to put in can become so convoluted and lead to unintended consequences. And that's something I think the NCAA membership will have to wrestle with as they figure out what to do from here.
And finally, the question that's on everyone's mind is, how could this impact Jimbo Fisher and Texas A&M?
Well, I'm not sure how it will impact Texas A&M. This is what we would call an investigation in the very, very preliminary exploratory stages. All we have at this point is the statement of a current student athlete who used to be at Texas A&M. The NCAA will have to do a lot more investigative work to figure out what it means, if any rules were violated. I don't think as of right now it's necessarily a significant problem for Texas A&M, but it could be, because the truth is you don't ever want NCAA investigators on your campus.